So I welcome Sri Anand, and we will enjoy the program as we have enjoyed in the previous two occasions. Okay, so I request Anand to speak now. Yes, Anand, we can continue.
Okay. Hi, hello everyone. Thanks for joining. So I thought I'll give a brief summary of the entire concept and what we are trying to talk about here, so that it will be useful for new joinees and also can act as a refresher for others. So this understanding, or the so-called, you know, we can also call it as a psychological freedom, a state of psychological freedom. So why do we need this, first of all? Let us just understand. See, we are doing so, we are involved in so many external activities, so many external events, right? But if you see, whatever external activities we are involved in, anything that is happening in the outside world can be experienced only through our mind, right? That is the window for our external world, right? Anything that you want to sense, anything that you want to experience, anything that you want to do, anything can be done only, you know, that can be experienced, you know, all of that only through the mind. So that acts as a window for our world, right? So that is why it is very crucial. And if you see what happens when there is a, you know, pleasure, of course we feel happy, and there is something which is not happening according to our wish, then there is a pain or discomfort created here. Again, which is happening in the mind only. So if you see, if you just simply, if you put, consolidate all the activities, and we can split it into pain and pleasure, or positive or negative, whichever is happening according to your wish, then you can term it as pleasure, or, you know, it's a positive action. And whichever is not happening to according to your wish, it's a negative one, or the pain. So the mind understands anything only through this pain and pleasure. These are the only two things it understands, right? It can be any different, it can be the form of various emotions, various thoughts or feelings. But finally, if you drill down, it is only, this is pain and this is pleasure. That's how it differentiates, right? So what happens is, since we do not know how to handle this mind, since mind forms, if you, as I just explained, that is the window for all our experiences. So whatever struggle we have, whatever problems we have, finally it hits the mind only as an experience. And this is where we are stuck with. So most of our energy, even if you take some situation, for example, you know, if you're having a bad a quarrel with somebody, if you have a fight with somebody, so immediately, you know, after, you know, when you have a fight with somebody, the experience that you feel, that is where you feel the pain, right? So what we are doing is, we are stuck more on handling our internal system. We are busy in handling our internal system, and actually, you know, spend very less amount of our time or energy in the actual external world where the real action is needed. So that is what we are trying to say. Our 80% of energy goes in handling this system itself, because we are fighting with our own self. We are trying to handle our own self. And 80% of energy goes in here, because this is what we do not know how to handle. External world activities, you know, even others can come and help you. Others can join with you and come and help you, talk on your behalf, work on your behalf, support you. All those things can be done. Or you can take advice, etc., etc. But whereas here, the pain and pleasure, whatever advice whoever gives, finally you only have to face it. You only have to come across, you only have to experience that pain and pleasure. That is only, you know, only you can do that, right? And that is what, that is where we struggle, because we do not know how to handle. And that is exactly, we are trying to solve this problem through this whole concept, which we call as Prabhavam. How is this different? So this is pretty different from the traditional approach to spirituality, because we are not talking about any spiritual beliefs or spiritual knowledge or any kind of mystical concepts, etc. Here it is completely scientific and logical. Anybody can just simply understand, and you can do an experiment and test it on your own. It is that simple. Only requirement is, you have to be really ready and open to test. Open in the sense, I mean, you should not have any conclusion to the end result. You should come with an open mind, test it out, see for yourself, understand the the logic or the concept that is being taught here, then you will be able to see the solution yourself. I don't have to tell you anymore. That simple is this concept actually. So coming to the concept, I'll just give a brief summary. So as I said, we all have body and mind. These are the only two instruments we have wherein we can experience anything at all. So in body, there are two functions. The other day also we spoke about, one is the involuntary functions or the auto functions, automatic things like, you know, your blood flow, your heartbeat, your functioning of your lungs, your digestive system and all these things, you know, it happens on its own, your breathing, all these things. And nobody will say that, you know, I forgot to breathe today because I was busy doing something, right? All that happens automatically on its own. This is the first part of it. Second part of it is the physical activities or the manual activity or the voluntary actions, willful actions that we do, which is like walking, running, going to office, working, etc. That is in our control. We can decide to go anywhere or we can decide to rest at home, etc. So similarly, mind also has two different functions. One is the auto function, which is called as thoughts or emotions, which occurs on its own. You don't have any control, because moment I see something, if I see my mobile, for example, when I see my mobile, moment maybe I'll think about, you know, my thought process will go somewhere else. It's like a chain reaction. It'll lead me somewhere else. I'll not be able to fix my thoughts to one specific thing, which as per my wish, it will keep on, you know, going like a chain reaction. So these thoughts, emotions occur depending on the external situation we are in and depending on my nature, how I've been brought up, what are my various beliefs, etc. Some emotions and thoughts will arise. So that's the auto part of it. The second part of it, the thinking, which is nothing but your planning skills, right? If I have to do some work, if I have to do a project, then I have to plan. I have to plan the schedule. Just think about how much of work required, what is the effort required, efficiency needed, all sort of stuff. So that's the thinking and planning. So mind also has two parts, right? One is the thought emotions, which is the automatic thing, and the willful action again, which is the planning and thinking, etc. Right? So where is the problem here? So these thoughts and emotions, which is the auto part, is not under our control, as I just said. Because if you see, if you just ask, you know, this will probably help you in experimenting this whole thing yourselves. I'll just give you a few tips, but you can do it offline. Just give you a few small hints of that. Things like, for example, if I think about, can I create a thought as per my own wish in a specific situation? You know, I want only this specific thought for the next 1 hour in this situation. Can I do that? No, that's not possible because it is not under our control. And the duration of the thought, you know, for example, can I restrict the thought that, you know, this thought should just stay with me only for 5 minutes and some other thought should stay with me for 5 hours. You cannot dictate such terms with the mind. And even the emotions, the intensity of the emotions, I cannot dictate and say that, you know, these emotions should impact me only with very less intensity, in a mild way. Whereas this emotion, a happy emotion, I want this in a bigger intensity, in a stronger. So this strong or lighter, the intensity of the emotions is not under my control. So if you see all these things, if you keep checking, testing it in your own system. So basically all these, the auto function, the thoughts and emotions is observed, but we have been brought up and we have a misconception that when thoughts and emotions arises within us, we feel that we have to do something. We have to take responsibility. We have to own, you know, if I have a bad or an ugly thought arising in my mind, we think that, oh, this is really bad. How can I have such a thought? This is, you know, I'm a stupid. How can I, you know, idiot. How can I have such a thought? You know, is what we feel because that's how we've been brought up from the beginning. So we want to own up and we want to take responsibility for these thoughts and emotions. So we don't have to own these thoughts and emotions. The only place where we have ownership is when these thoughts and emotions get converted to actions, right? Suppose if I get angry, anger on some incident and angry on somebody. So the anger, the arising of anger is not a problem. That is very natural. We have to simply accept it. We don't have any control on that. But whereas expressing that anger or using that anger on somebody else and speaking, shouting at them or, giving a slap on them, etc. That is the action that is definitely under our control. Because you will not express in every situation, right? Suppose you may feel angry in a certain situation, but you will only express wherever it is appropriate, wherever you have the right to do so, wherever you have the authority to do so, right? Suppose if your boss shouts at you, you will not be able to express your anger at that point of time. But if somebody, somebody junior, a junior staff shouts at you, or if you become angry with him, you will easily be able to express. So the point is, wherever you feel that you have the authority or the empowerment to express or to show your this one, we take that action. So we use that intelligence. It is just that it happens very fast. It just happens in, millisecond or whatever. So we immediately react, but our intelligence works. Actually, there is an intelligence portion which happens, which works in between the thought and the action. So that is what we need to take care of. We don't have to own the responsibility for the emotions and thoughts which arises, only for the actions. These thoughts and arise, the actions which are driven from these experiences. So that is our responsibility. So our only effort. So if you were able to see all these and conclude, if you were able to experiment and test it on your own, then you can come to a conclusion that these thoughts and emotions are not at all under my control. I don't have any role to play. You can shut this area completely. This is like a no entry. You don't have to use your intelligence, start thinking about why am I feeling angry, or why am I feeling worried, why am I sad. All these are not needed. That happens naturally. Your focus should be only on the external world activities. What can I do? How can I address the situation better? How can I handle this situation next time in a better manner? How can I handle the relationship better? How can I handle my work better? How can I handle my work pressure better? So these are the things. So this is the crux of the whole concept that we're talking about. So I just thought I will give a quick brief, which will be helpful to you. So I think now we can get to the question answer.
Okay. So before going into that, I'll just get a feedback from the people that how's the audio they are feeling. I'm finding it okay. I just asked some couple of people who are Shanti from US. How is the audio that you are feeling?
Yeah, I'm good. I can hear very
well. Okay, so there is no problem. That is fine. One more person I will ask. Rohini is there. Unmute. Rohini, you are from US, I think, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, how is the audio? Right?
It's perfect.
Okay, that means we can go ahead. Then I mute both of you. Wait for a good chances. Okay, then. Sanjay Srivastava has come. Okay, this is the place where you ask the question and Anandji gives the clarifications and we can have a mutual discussion, arguments. Okay. We can have all the thing on our, then again we will repeat it after some time. Okay. For persons who want to ask the question, raise up hands option, which is available in the system. So Sanjay Srivastava has come up. I'm giving unmute to him. You can ask the question and discuss with him. Anand.
Hello, Namaste Anandji.
Hi, hello Sanjay. Hi.
Yeah, then you say what is not in our control. So I have an issue with that. Because when you say that, I can understand that you cannot hold a thought for 5 hours or 1 hour. But if you say that you think of some, say, blue car, I can think of it. So it is not that I can understand that I do not have absolute control over thoughts. But it is not correct to say that you do not have any control. There is a lot of middle ground between no control and absolute control. We have some limited control on thoughts.
Okay. So if, as you just rightly said, thinking of blue car or whatever. So that is thinking. That's what I said. That's the manual portion where you think about something, yes, that's what we said, right? The manual portion where you have some control and you have some, you know, flexibility, or you can do it willfully. But that is not the real. For example, anger, for example, right? If you take anger or even happiness, etc., you cannot create.
The emotion, I'm pretty much sure that emotion is not in our control.
Yeah, similarly.
My point was.
Yeah, so that's what you are talking about thinking here, right? I said manually you can do, as you said, there is a certain portion where you can manually do something, which we call as thinking, because you are doing it manually. The verb, that's why we call it in the verb form. You're doing it manually, right? You are thinking about it. What the problem is, see, where is the problem actually? If you see, it's not about thinking, right? Because you will think about, if you have any need for thinking, or if you have some work, any activity related thinking, that's what you're going to think about, right? If you don't need something and if still something comes up on its own, so that is what we consider as a problem, right? Otherwise, thinking is not at all a problem. Only when it goes beyond your control, when you say, it goes beyond my control, or when you say that I do not want these thoughts, it's coming again and again. So that is what we say. That is where we get stuck. So which comes on its own, that is what I'm trying to say, not the thinking portion.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. But even for thinking, I would say that thinking also, I do not decide that today I will brood over my misfortunes. That impulse to thinking also comes naturally.
Correct. That's what I'm saying. Whatever you do manually, you decide and do something, right? That is what we call as thinking. Whatever happens on its own, even you do not, for example, you said, you may say that I do not want to brood over my worries or whatever incident that happened yesterday. Some negative incident happened. I do not want to keep on worrying about it. That's your decision. But does it listen to you? You may start worrying about it even without your knowledge, sometimes unconsciously. Yeah. So that is the part I'm talking about, not the one under your control. Your control, yes, absolutely. You can do willfully. Whatever you want to do, you can do. But the problem is, this is the portion where we are stuck, right? Not the one which it isn't in our control. The portion we have a problem is the one which is not under our control.
So, in a sense, what we are saying, that thoughts which are not in our control, they are not in our control.
Exactly.
Yeah,
because we have a misconception, right? Like how you were asking, right? Suppose if I start worrying about an incident, some bad incident happened at my home or office, right? Suppose I start worrying about that incident, we feel guilty about it. We feel that, how can I worry about it? I have read so many books. I've read so many concepts. I know so many spiritual concepts and this and that. I'm so matured. How can I really, how can this anger come inside me? How can this worry happen to me? How can I feel guilty? How can I feel depressed? How can I feel sorrow? This is what we are stuck with, right? So what we are saying is, it's a misconception. You don't have to own up whatever is happening inside. You don't have to own up everything that is happening inside. Certain things are happening on its own. It is not under our control. You can simply allow it. If you allow it, actually, you will see that you will see the magic yourself, that it is just actually disappearing on its own. The problem is, it is not disappearing now because you are giving life to it by thinking about it again and again, because it's memory, right? You're thinking about that incident and thinking about that emotion, that negative incident or the emotion again and again and again and again, feeling guilty about it, again feeling worried about it. It's like a cycle. It becomes more and more complicated. First, actually, you start worrying about one thing, then you start worrying about that you are worrying on now. First, you start worrying about an incident. Next, what happens is you start worrying about that you are worrying now. So it's like going on a cycle. It goes on a cycle like this. And the problem becomes bigger and bigger only because of your intervention. If you decide that I'm not going to intervene, and if you understand that, there is no need to intervene, then things will flow as is. That's what I think gave an example the other day. If you take a small bowl and pour water in it, if there is some disturbance caused in that water, it will form the ripples and waves in the water, right? That is the emotions or the negative thoughts or the worries and sorrow which we are referring here, right? So how do we stop that? if you try to do something, if you try to manipulate that and try to take some actions, it will only complicate the whole things, because you will introduce more and more waves, more and more ripples. That cycle will go on and on and on and on endlessly. So when will that end? Once you understand that this ripple is going to, you know, die down on its own, if I simply keep quiet and take my hand off, these waves will subside on its own. If you understand that, it will go down in no time. So same thing is happening to our thoughts. We have a misconception that I have to go and do something inside and act on it. Then only the anger will go away. Then only my worry will go away. That's the misconception we have. That is what we are trying to clarify here, that we don't have to do anything. If you simply keep quiet, it will go on its own. Is that clear?
Yeah, okay, thank you.
Yeah.
Sanjay, you got a question further on this? Sanjay, you are able to hear?
I think he said it is clear, so probably.
Okay, then fine. Then I'll give mute and wait for the next occasion for the question. You want to ask the question, use raise hands raise option. Gopal Swami from Chennai has come. Are you unmuted?
Okay.
Yes, Gopal Swami, you can ask.
Yes. As Mr. Anand told me rightly, but we cannot leave all emotions, we cannot let allow all emotions freely, because all the emotion is coming for solution only. It is seeking some solution. When worry is coming, means it is seeking for some solution from our mind. So we should attend that one. What is solution is required? We should find out. No, we cannot simply allow to flow. No, we should why it is that worry is coming. We should analyze and we should try to find out the solution. If you don't find solution, again that it will repeat. It will come out. It will keep on coming. No, so like that, all emotions, it is coming for some reason. So it is asking for seeking for solution. We should attend. No, we cannot simply leave it. No.
Yeah, yeah. You're true. It is true that emotions are coming. You know, most of the times it would be coming for some reason, and it is expecting us to act on the external world or the situation we are in. Yes, obviously, if it is useful to work in the external world and correct some things, to do some things, yes, we can definitely use that. There is nothing wrong in that. Only when it's a problem, when we are stuck in that, right? That's the problem we are all facing, right? If we can simply execute and use it in the external world, then we will not have any problem. Only, you know, if there is a problem, we can, and this is the solution that we're talking about. If it is useful to act in the external world, absolutely, you know, we are free to use it as required.
In that sense, we should attend all emotions, why it is coming, and we should try to give the solution. No, we cannot simply leave it. If you leave it, then again it will come. Definitely it will come. So suppose somebody for our close friend or somebody died, that feeling is coming. So we should give some answer to our emotion. Say yes, he has died, we cannot do anything, something we should satisfy our mind. Otherwise, again, it will keep on coming. No, if you give some solution, then it will not come again, isn't it? If you don't give again, it keep on coming, and it will be a problem. No?
Yeah. So if there is a solution possible in the external world, then definitely, as I said, you know, definitely it is, you know, we can do that. If you're looking for a solution inside, like in the example you said, if somebody is already dead, somebody has died, then there is nothing you can do in the external world. These emotions will keep coming on its own. You don't have to answer, because what we are saying is you don't even have to answer. You don't even have that responsibility, or even that effort is required, because it is anyway going to subside. If you simply take off, back off, it is anyway going to subside. If there is no problem, then you don't need to attend or, you know, do any experiment or and keep answering. So that is not needed, is what we are saying. If you want to do, yes, that is up to you.
No, and when it comes first time, if you give the answer by yourself, then it will not come, it will not repeat again. If you don't give answer, it keep on coming. No, that even you are telling that you can, you should not attend, just keep allow you are telling, but still it will be disturbing us. But if you give correct solution to that, it will not repeat, isn't it? That whatever, just for example, I told, many worries are coming for solution only. So we should, if you properly, if you give answer, and then it will not come. See, there is no internal and external, all of only one thing only. Whatever external, our mind is acting on that, that's all. So everything it is asking for some solution, isn't it? All our thoughts are coming, worries or anger or anything, it is for some solution only is asking. So so we should give, isn't it? We cannot leave it, no?
Okay, two things. As I said, you know, if it is asking for some solution and if there is a scope to do something, yes, of course, as I said, you know, we can definitely do that. There is nothing wrong in that. If there is no scope for any solution, because every activity, every action will not have, you will not have scope in every situation. Only in some situations you will have scope to do something and some other situations you will not have scope to do something. So what we are saying is you don't have to, because now what happens is we are stuck in these emotions. Instead of working or correcting the situation, we are busy fighting with our own selves on against these emotions and thoughts which are coming. So we are busy here. Our 80% energy is going here, struggling here, than putting our efforts in the external activity. So we just have to understand that. And if you can use these emotions as a trigger, as a drive point and act in the external world, yes, that is definitely welcome. You can use that. But you don't have to worry about these emotions, is what we are saying. Leaving or whatever, I mean, the terminology which may use, the point we are saying is we don't have to worry about it because it's anyway going to subside. You can simply focus on the external action, whatever is needed for the situation, you can simply focus on that. You don't have to worry about these things, is what we are saying.
You are attending external action, that is okay, no problem.
Yeah.
But internally is coming and for some solution, that also we need to attend, isn't it? It's also related to external only. That also we have to attend, no?
Yeah, what I'm saying is you don't have to say that I should not get angry, right? We only have to do whatever is required in the situation, external situation. You don't have to say that I should not be worried for because of this incident happened. You need not fight against those worries. You don't have to answer those worries. You can simply go and correct the situation, if possible, for whatever that has caused the worry. That's what we are saying.
Okay, I agree. But in that case, still we are giving some concern on our emotion, isn't it? We are not leaving, isn't it?
I mean, I don't know how, whatever terms you want to call, this is what we are saying. You don't have to worry and you can simply leave it as it is because it's anyway going to subside and you're not responsible for that.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Gopal Swami. I'm muting you. Shanti from USC is meeting now. I'm giving unmute. Yeah, Shanti, you can talk.
Yeah. Sir, good morning. Actually, my bandwidth is a little low, so I'm not giving my video. I'm sorry about that. So my question is that the other people's negative thoughts, for example, so jealous. I'll take one of the examples, so jealous. If they take that into an action and start interfering my action, that is actually the scenario. So that is what happened. But I didn't get much disturbed about that. But for discussion purpose, I want to explain that situation. It was long back, 6 months or 8 months ago. I'll tell you the situation. Actually, here we have like Telugu, Hindi speaking and Tamil speaking people. So I'm very friendly with all those language people. So one or two people from Tamil and from Telugu, they got so jealous on me and then they started giving some rumors about that to other people. That is like spoiling the name. So here in US, there is some law, civil law. If you're spoiling the other's name, they can put the law like that. So it is human nature all over the world. But just for discussion purpose, it was long back. So I just want to discuss about this scenario. So if our negative thoughts, we can deal with that. Right, we just take it into a for motivation purpose and give good things to the external actions. But if somebody else, like other people's motivation is not good and they interfere into our actions, means so what kind of, because this is like first time I was like little embarrassed after hearing about that, but then I was not disturbed or not bothered about that. But I just want to discuss about this scenario in this occasion. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So first of all, external world people, I mean, obviously they will behave in different ways. We cannot expect them to behave in a fair manner, in a manner that you like or that you wish, right? So people will behave in different ways. So all these negative energy, jealousy, whatever, so that is up to them. So we don't have to worry about, of course you can have a concern and you can try to explain and you can try to help them. But what should I do is whatever is required in that situation, forget about whether he is being jealous or throwing negative energy, whatever. So for that situation, whatever is appropriate, according to your intelligence, according to your experience, or, I mean, of course you can take advice from others also. So it is only the external situation, right? We don't have to feel because of the negative energy, if it is triggering some emotions inside us, like for example, you may feel hurt or insulted, those kind of things. So that we don't need to worry about it, because that is in the form of emotions and thoughts, which is our internal psychological system, which we don't have to worry about. But whatever is required in the situation, that external situation, the action required, so that is where you need to focus on. We don't have to focus on the emotions that get triggered because of somebody has hurt you or somebody has thrown negative energy on you. Is that fine?
Yeah, fine. Yeah. So like before I thought it is bad, their actions were, it's not good like that. I was a little, this kind of things I never faced, because before we were so innocent, we just focus on our own improvement, right? But later, once we are clear about that, started looking into other people's actions, means so somewhat it was focusing on this, what kind of people they are like that. My focus went into it. And then later, Aya's speech and those things teach that, okay, that is fine. If it happens to us, before I couldn't categorize, this is negative, this is positive. So negative things is helping us to improve the external activities. But now, if that is happening to us, we will take in this way. But if it happens from others, like from external person, so that is... you are inside the part of their negative means, so we need to do some actions. I mean, either you don't bother about them or just avoid them, or just I just avoided that. I never, after that, I didn't go further about that. So I just avoided them and stopped, calm, and I maintain some distance. That's it. I didn't do anything else, and it was now solved, and we are again friendly. But since I want to this experience, this experience made me to know it's a lesson. Like, yeah. So this kind of things, it happens in every human beings, and this is an experience. I just want to share my experience and come to a discussion about those things also.
Sure.
Yeah.
Sure. Thanks. Yeah.
Yeah, right.
Thank you, Shanti, so much. Okay. So next, anybody want to ask a question? Yeah, Sanjay Srivastava has come back. Unmute. He has come from Rajasthan. Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Proceed. So this tendency to set right our psychological world, it is universal. It is cutting across all cultures. I mean, everybody does it. You, whenever you have some psychological pain or psychological discomfort, you want to avoid it. So it must have some, it must be fulfilling some function. That's why it is here in the human organism.
Okay, good question. So actually, this is again because of the conditioning that we have developed. If you see a child, will not have any such worries. You know, even if he is worried or sad, he will be fully into, I mean, he will not be separated. He will, you know, for example, now, if you see how we are feeding the worries, there is a person who is worried about his worries. That's how we see, right? There is a separation. It's like divided into two. We feel that I am angry. And then there is an anger. So we are trying to work on that anger. I'm worried and we are working on those worries and trying to get rid of that worry. So there is a separation which is happening here. But if you see, whereas if you see in a child, it will be a, there will be no separation. If he is worried, he will be completely worried. He will not be worried about his worries. He will not be bothered about why is he worried. He will not be questioning that, why am I experiencing like this, right? There will be nothing, no other question. Whatever emotion, thought that he is into at that moment, he'll be simply be with it. He will not have any separation inside. That's how a child is, right? So, sorry, she has mentioned. Okay, that's how a child is. So slowly after, once we grow up, then we develop all these conditioning comes inside us because we've been taught from childhood that, no, you cannot be angry. Angry is a negative thing. How can you have a negative emotion? You cannot be worried. Worry is a negative emotion. You should always be happy. You cannot be jealous. It's a negative emotion. So all these things that has come into us. So then we started. So the problem is the context or the intention may be good. You know, all those people whoever has conveyed that. But that is required. The action is required to get rid of them. The action is required only in the external world. So that is where we need to take care of that. These, whether it is anger or jealousy, whatever. In our actions, we need to take care of them in our actions. But we use the same language, same logic in our psychological system also. That is where the problem. See, a simple example would be, everything is nature, right? The whole thing is natural. Even the earth, you know, the whole galaxy, every moment, even in your body, every cells, every moment, it is the cells are, some cells are, you know, dying and some other cells are born, right? That's how every moment there is a change. Nothing is still. Nothing is standing still in front of you. Every moment, the whole universe, including we, there is a change every moment. Similarly, this mind, which is the natural part, like as we just spoke about some time back, these thoughts and emotions, they come on their own. Whatever you are doing manually, that's different. I'm not talking about that. The portion which happens on its own, that's also nature, right? It happens every moment. But we tend to misconceive that if there is a worry, there is a worry sitting with me for 1 hour. We assume that we actually misconceive something like that. But it is not true. That worry, if it is staying for 1 hour, for example, you are worrying about it every moment. You are thinking about it again and again, again and again and again, every moment throughout that 1 hour. So that is why it is staying with you. If you don't think about it, it will automatically pass. It's like a compartment of a train passing in a platform. Every moment there is a thought. Nothing is staying permanently with us. But we have that misconception because of our memory. Like how you see in this manual picture those days in movies, right? The picture frame will be running 24 frames per second or whatever. But you will see a still picture in the screen. Similarly, even these thoughts, emotions, they just keep on every moment it's just passing, right? New emotions and thoughts. But using our, because of our memory, we tend to see that, you know, there is something I am anger for the last 1 hour or things like that. Because of the memory, we try to retain and keep on getting that feeling that, you know, there is something sitting for a longer period of time. So that is the misconception that we have. So this is the problem that we are stuck with. The solution is we don't have to own this because you can see it for yourself. What I'm saying is you don't have to believe it. This is not a concept. You can test it out. It is pure science. So many of us have tested. I have tested it myself. And I've seen that it is just, if you don't attend to it, it simply goes on its own. It is like Aya used to say, give good examples. Like, you know, there is a, if you sit in front of your house, just in the veranda, there may be so many, you know, vehicle shopkeepers will be plying on the road. Somebody might be selling some plastic goods, somebody vegetables, fruits, etc. So you don't have to, if you do not want some of those things, you don't have to tell them that, no, please go. No, he will keep on passing your house. Everybody will keep passing on your house. Only if you want something, if you want to buy something, you can call them and take that. So that is the external action. If you do not want that, if you do not want these emotions and thoughts, you know, which you dislike, the negative emotions and thoughts, it will go away on its own. It is only because if you call, that shopkeeper will come inside and give you those things. So that's how it happens inside also.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, Sanjay ji. Krishna Sharma, I think he wanted to ask a question. I give unmute. Please tell me from where you are calling. Yes, Krishna Sharma, you can speak now.
Yes. I am Krishna Sharma from Bangalore, sir.
Hello, sir.
I read a lot of philosophy books, but one problem is again and again I am facing. That is guilty feelings in the mind. Repetitive guilty feelings, which I have done in my childhood. No doubt they are all wrongs. I know it. But that guilty feeling is not going out of the mind and it is causing a lot of worries and not able to sleep night times. What is the best solution for those things?
Okay. Have you read any of these books or videos, this Pravagam concept?
One or two books only.
One or two books, okay. So maybe, I mean, there is a specific about this guilty consciousness, especially, I mean, I just explained anyway, it's the same concept again.
Yes, sir.
Thoughts, yeah. So our mind has two portions, as I just mentioned. One is the thought, which happens, occurs on its own. And there is the manual portion where you can think about it. You can do thinking and planning and, you know, do on top of that. So these thoughts and emotions that come up on their own, we don't have to worry. Only if you start fighting with that, only if you start thinking about or working against or trying to find a solution, is again working against it, right? Trying to do something. Only when you step in and try to do something, you are actually complicating the whole problem. So same is with guilty feelings also. Guilty yes. feeling is, what is guilty feeling is that, you know, some thoughts, have, some emotions or thoughts have come in you and you're feeling that you're having a rule, I mean, you're having a rule or condition that that should not happen to me. How can it happen to me?
It should not
maybe
do it.
Some vulgar thought or something must have happened, for example.
Yes, yes.
And you, we feel that, you know, how can it occur to me? I mean, I'm so experienced, so much educated and I've done so many, you know, spiritual books. I've read so many spiritual books, etc. So we have that condition or we have put up a rule in our mind. That this should not happen. These 1, 2, 3 things should happen. These 1, 2, 3 things should not happen. So we have this rule book and we expect that our mind should react in this way according to our rule book. And this rule book, how have we formed? Based on some conditioning, some book we have read, some videos we have seen, without even analyzing anything, without even understanding how this mind functions. We have framed some rules, set of rules in our own mind about our own self. But that is not correct, right? We cannot expect the mind to act according to our rules. So that is why we need to understand how the mind functions. And there is these two separate portions called thought, which occurs on its own. We don't have to own. We don't have to worry. Then there is a thinking. That is where we need to act on, or the external world related thing. So, I mean, if you have more questions, maybe we can discuss in detail offline. Or
what is that specific book, sir? Should I read?
There is a specific thought and thinking, and I'll also check if there is anything which addresses the guilty feeling which you specifically mentioned.
I will put in this one in the chat box my email ID.
Sure.
If it is available, please send it to me, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Krishna Sharma. See, there is a hand size option that is available at the bottom of the screen. Next time, when you can just read, see it, and then use that.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes,
I mean,
sir.
One Hema Felici helped me that you are interested by showing the hand size option. Okay, Satya ji, she wants to talk. I give unmute.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
So Anand ji is saying all the vendors are going by and everything. The negativity is also the negativity which we have inside that makes us attract towards the same negativity outside.
So I think it was breaking in between.
Can you hear me?
It was breaking in between. What's
can you hear me?
Yes, we can.
Sir?
Yeah, we can.
Satya, you can repeat the question because it was breaking in between when we were... you can speak
can
again.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah, see, the vendors are all going by on the road and we want something, so we call them. The same way, the negativity, we attract them from what we have inside.
Okay. So what I said, I think I was explaining that calling the vendors means that for your external action, suppose, for example, anger is always seen as a bad emotion.
Psychologically,
right?
Psychologically.
Yeah, that's what this calling a
psychologically
vendor,
when we keep on delivering.
So this calling a vendor means that it is for the external action, not for the psychological. I was just saying that if you want some emotion, for example, anger is not, it's not a bad emotion always, because suppose if you're working in your office or if you have to manage some people, then you may have to act angry also. You may have to use that anger and use the drive and push people to do some certain things. So it's not that it should not be there at all. Right. So that was what I was trying to say.
Yeah, but when we start lingering on the same thing, print or some pattern that is there inside, which attracts the same negativity or whatever.
Your voice is breaking in between.
Your voice is not audible, Satya.
Yeah, there's a chat, very low. Okay, doesn't matter. I'll ask another time.
What you can do is, if you can send a question in the chat box, then Anandji will try to reply on that.
Wait. Ditu, Wi-Fi irka?
Yeah, yes.
Hello? Now you can hear me?
Yes, now it is better.
Now it's okay?
It is better.
Yeah. No, what I want to know is, you're saying when there is a need, we call the vendor. That is outside action you're talking about. Hello?
Correct.
I am talking about psychologically, you start lingering on the same thing. You don't move out of that. Like, blaming the other person who has negativity. But is it our negativity that is attracting the other negativity all the time? Something that is within us.
Okay, so whether it is our negativity or his negativity or somebody else's negativity, as initially I was explaining, right? Whatever you experience is only through this mind, only through pain and pleasure, right? There's nothing else. You don't have any other tools. All your world experiences only through pain and pleasure. If you're complaining about something, it is a pain, right? If you're enjoying something,
true.
It's pleasure.
True, but then why am I attracting the same thing?
That's what
my mind thinks only about that.
That's what I'm saying. If it is happening, see, nobody will attract voluntarily, right? If you have a choice, will you attract negativity? No, right?
No.
Right? So that exactly explains it is out of your choice. It happens on its own. So whatever happens on its own, all those are thoughts, the automatic portion.
Okay. Yeah,
you don't have to, you can give a damn to all that. You can simply focus on what is under your control. That's all.
Okay. I understand. Thank you.
Satyaji, I'll mute.
If
anybody have a question, kindly raise the hand up then. Yeah, Rohini, I think she has come from US, if I am sure.
Yeah, hi.
Hello.
Hi.
Yes, Rohini.
Right. Yeah, so my question is, what if we don't have any external things to do, like say we are on a vacation or we are just taking rest, and if something bad happens at that time, then it looks like we are depending on the action to get out of the emotions, right? And what if we don't have anything to do immediately?
Okay. You're talking about if you don't have any action to do, but you are having some negative emotions or something.
At that time, when you are just taking rest or if you're on a vacation, for example.
Yeah. So that is bound to happen, right? Obviously, mind, that is nature's, that is the nature of mind. Mind will keep on chewing about some past incidents or imagining about what to do in future. So it will keep on lingering, all these things. That is why we are saying that, that this is bound to happen and it is not under your control. We don't have to bother. We don't have to own up for that. So like you're asking, what should I do? You don't have to do because you have not created that. Because if you have the choice to create, you will create all beautiful, pleasant feelings. Nobody will choose negative, worry, you know, sorrow feelings, right? So the very fact that it is not happening according to your, I mean, the very fact that those are negative and uncomfortable feelings, it means that you have not brought them in. It is happening on its own. That is nature. You can simply allow it as it is. Nothing, it's not going, you don't have to worry about it. And simply focus on whatever external actions possible. That's all.
Okay, so external actions possible is a question. Suppose we want to take rest and you don't want to do anything externally. So then yeah. I think it's a little challenging at that time is what my comment yeah. was.
Yeah, so the point is, I think maybe, I'm not sure if you've gone through this. So we always say that in generally, in external world activities, we have to achieve success. Right. If I have to finish some work in the external world, then I have to do hard work and they do all gain all knowledge, gather all knowledge and do some hard work and then achieve success. That's in the external world. Here in the internal world or the psychological world is concerned, success is not the criteria here. Here failure is the criteria. Because what is the failure we're talking about is because always we interfere and disturb this whole free flowing thoughts and emotions. Thinking that I have the responsibility and I'm going to correct it. I'm going to fine tune it. I'm going to shape up and do something like we were seeing that water example, right? It's the same thing that we are talking about, right? See, the water is the ripples or the waves is the negative emotions. Thinking that I am going to do something, you know, I have some role to play and you start putting your hand in it and trying to disturb this and you will only create more and more ripples, more and more waves. So that is why we are saying that in this portion of thoughts and emotions, you don't have any role to play. You have to simply accept your failure, your defeat against the nature there. So here, when you say it is challenging, when will it be challenging? Challenging will be only if I want you to successfully do something, successfully achieve something, then only it will be challenging, right? If I say, please fail, don't do anything, accept your failure, defeat, get defeated, bow down, accept, surrender. That's what we are saying, right? Then there is no question of, even if you are not able to defeat, then that's accept that also as a defeat. Even if you're not able to stop your interference, accept that, you know, that you're not able to stop your interference because that is also an automatic system that is happening inside. So surrender completely is the point that we are trying to say here. Is that clear, Shanti? She has got muted.
One minute. It was from Rohini, right?
Oh, sorry. Yeah, Rohini, correct. Yeah. Can you unmute her? Or?
I'm trying.
Yeah. Now she is unmuted.
Hello?
Yes.
Sorry. I'm sorry. I muted myself because there was some background noise here. Okay. And then I was not able to unmute. So, So I think the surrender thing is probably the right thing. Because sometimes when I listen to talks, I kind of understood that we shouldn't bother about the emotions. And if it's important for the external action, take it. Otherwise, just concentrate on the external action. That's why I got the doubt that what if we don't have any external action at that time?
Yeah.
So it looks like instead of relying on the external action to change our mind, instead of that, just surrender to whatever comes.
Exactly.
That will be
exactly.
More appropriate.
And surrender is not an action here. Surrender is just getting defeated.
Mm,
no,
yes.
Accepting your defeat. That's all.
Yes.
Yeah.
And I want to thank you and Babulal sir and Muthulakshmi madam and the entire mission for the wonderful work that you are doing. So thank you very, very much.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you so much, Rohini. Next, Shintan and Priya family want to talk to us. Unmute her. Yes,
indeed. Yeah. Good evening, sir.
Yeah,
can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Good evening.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you for the clarification. It's pretty clear. My question is related to the previous person. I think her name is Rohini or something. It's related to that. What I have done, to give an example, there was an issue. I have taken an action to address that situation, taking IAS guidance. But despite taking that action, I know the action has been completed, but there is an underlying sense of a fear. For example, I don't want to really address that, but the subtle fear is always there despite the action being taken. So in this case, should I surrender or leave it as it is? Because it's not, I don't want to try also, but the feeling is still there, the fear. So what kind of response, or is there a response required first of all? If not, what is actually, in this situation, after an action being taken, the feeling is still there. So I just want your advice or suggestion.
Yeah, thanks. Yeah, thanks. Yeah, so as you said, if the external action has already been taken and still you are having some fear, it could be for some reason. It could be saying, because that you can choose a better option. Maybe you want to evaluate and try another action and maybe do it better in a better manner. So it could be doing all the trigger. Mind could be coming up with all such triggers. But as you said, if you think that the scope is over and the action is complete, then whatever happens, you don't have to bother at all. It is simply some emotions and thoughts. That is natural. So you don't have to worry about it at all.
Okay, sure. Thank you.
You called it from... I'll just unmute. Just for recording purpose. Central, you had called from...
I called from Singapore.
Oh, great. Okay, fine.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Satya,
Unmute? Yeah. Can you speak?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, you. Anandji.
Yes, madam.
You explained it very well. See, now I have the clarity. See, when it is. What is this?
Senthil, you have to mute.
No, okay.
Yeah, now we can continue.
You had explained it very clearly. That is, yeah. Thinking that we have something to do with it, we keep on prolonging with it. We don't surrender or accept the inevitability. That makes it, keep the mind keeps on bringing the same issue again and again. If you just accept this is how it is, at least it will subside. It will go away. We don't allow it. We keep on persisting on the same thing and it keeps on coming and forming like a pattern,
Exactly. True.
So this very true.
Yeah, you can see it. Suppose if you're going on a vacation or a trip, you have to catch a train, for example, right? And you're getting delayed. So you'll be really frustrated or feeling restless until you reach the, station on time.
Yeah.
Right. You will be always feeling restless continuously. You will try to catch a taxi, cab, auto, whatever it is. You will be feeling that restlessness feeling will be there because you want to try and do something. But the moment you know that train has already left, and there is no choice, no option.
So the psychological level, we just take it in our hands as though we can solve and resolve and our business and all that.
Exactly.
You are thinking that there is something. It is very, very hard when you are involved in it. It is so, even if you have all the wisdom in the world, when you are involved in that, it's so at that moment in that problem, it's very, very hard to come out of it.
It's sometimes it can be tricky and it can be initially, there will be a struggle because we were always from the childhood told to go in this direction. Now we are saying we are giving an opposite direction. So there will be a little struggle during that opposite direction.
Yeah.
But once you are clear with this concept, then it will be fantastic journey.
Yeah. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Okay. Venkatesan from Nigeria. You want to unmute?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Just one question just to pop up there. I was thinking to ask you. See this, as you said, from the childhood, we are conditioned in so many ways, like a father, mother, and traditional, and then culture, friends, everybody. So that conditioning, is always of dominating in our mind. Like that you are saying. But can it not be possible to remove all the condition in a by insight or understanding? Can it not be possible to remove all the conditioning?
Yeah, so that is exactly what is happening here, right? Because once you understand that there is a nature and which takes care of all these emotions and thoughts and whatever arises inside, then you are completely free from all these psychological stuff. So whatever you have is only in the external world. External world, you have to use your knowledge and science and logic to handle your external actions. There is no, you don't have to depend on your conditioning there. You have to go by the situation. You have to go what is appropriate for the situation there. That's all. Right?
Yeah, I understand. Yeah, that's clear. Eh? But one thing is, see, when I look at this, my particularly job, when everybody is working, everybody is trying to work, but we play a role in a society, see, we work. But when we look at it, when we are, I feel that we are selected a particular job and then we are going every day office and doing job. That is not only a just aspect of life. It is not so. I feel like that. Some of them is coming out in my mind that, so what is this all this one? Yeah.
Yeah. So that is up to our choice, right? How we want to live in the external world. There is no such rule. It is up to our choice. If you want to do something else other than doing your work, if you want to do some, for example, charity work or something which will give you, make you satisfied or whatever, you can take care of, you can do all that. That is, nobody is going to stop that. So our role, what we are talking about, this understanding is only about psychological world, wherein we don't have to, if you just put a full stop and say that I don't have to take care of this psychological thing, then you will be completely free inside. Then you can act in the outside according to our dharma and the rules, society rules and regulations. Whatever you want to do, it is up to you.
Yeah, I understand. Yeah. So the another thing aspect is like a perception, because what we see, this five senses are there, and then I was not knowing at all about mind. That also is a sense. So after reading, that much, that is very clear. So now, if you look at it, all the senses, like all the taste and seeing and hearing, everything, all the senses are already liberated, because it doesn't hold anything. It doesn't hold any information, and it is only just reflecting everything what is coming on that senses. But all the informations are going to our mind and storing there. But the technical aspect of storing is not no issue at all, because without technical knowledge, we cannot work in the physical world. But the psychological aspect is storing in our mind. But is it naturally happen, or how it has happened? How it is happening here?
Yeah.
And is it not possible to not to record at all? Because something happening and thinking that kind of way it is coming.
Yeah. So see, all these again,
what
as
is
you
needed
said,
in that particular period? Say, yeah.
Yeah. As you said, it is definitely natural. We are inbuilt with all these memories, and I mean, every being, I think, inbuilt with all these memory and all these faculties for us. Finally, for survival only, for our survival. But everything may not get recorded. It is only things for which you give importance, right? Because you may come across 1,000 things, some 1,000 thoughts. Even now, you may watch, you may be listening to me, but some other things may be, you may be going around. Some other things may also come up. But if you don't give importance to that, that will not get recorded, right? Whatever you give importance, whatever is important to you at that point of time, only those critical things will get recorded. Every event, everything we see, every thought will not get recorded. I mean, you will not be able to remember also.
Yeah, that's absolutely clear. Yeah,
you get recorded, but it will be
Yeah, that's very clear. Yeah, because if I look at it yesterday, what kind of food I taken, I don't remember.
Exactly.
But the worst month before, what food kind of food we had taken, we don't remember.
Yes.
But if it's a practical aspect, whatever job we technically we do, it is record. But what is happening, what I'm asking is psychological aspect. Suppose shouted, yesterday somebody shouted. That is getting recorded immediately. Why now? Is there something needed not to record that one? Because why it is recording? Is it because of we are not alert and that situation, we are not alert or we are not attentive?
No. Again, even here also, even these emotions also, if somebody, suppose you're driving on the road and, you've hit somebody and somebody is shouting at you, just showing hands, some stranger, it will not, I mean, if it is not a real serious situation, then it will not get recorded. After 1 month, you may forget, right? But if somebody whom you are meeting every day, whom you are concerned about, whom you are related to, if he insults you, then it will hurt more. Then it depends on the impact and the importance you give. Only those will get recorded. Small things, if it is not hurting you at all, or if it's of a trivial thing, then you will just dismiss it and just, you know, you will leave it as is, and then it may not get recorded. But the point here is whether it records, even for example, even if it, this recording is also for our survival, it is all for survival and help only. It is not that it is bad. It's a bad thing. Because for example, if somebody has shouted at you, you will remember it next time, right? Next week, if you're going to meet that same person, you will remember that what happened last time. So at least this time, let me try and avoid, do something else or correct the situation so that he will not shout at me this time. So you will be able to take that action, right? So that is the purpose of it. If there is no action needed, if there is no scope, then you don't have to worry. Even if it gets recorded, let it be. Whatever is happening inside our system, we don't have to bother about it. That's what I said, right? Everything is pain, pleasure, emotions, thoughts, all that is going to be in our mind only. Whatever you do physically in the external world, that is all it matters. For example, you will not be able to, if I'm, you know, if we are meeting, suppose you are my friend, if I am meeting you, you will not be able to see my, whatever is going on, my thoughts and emotions in my mind. You will only see my actions, right? You will not be able to see what I am thinking. You will only see what I am doing to you. How am I greeting you? How am I, you know, receiving you? So those kind of things, whatever is my actions is what will be visible in the external world. Only that is where we need to focus on. Internal world, there is nothing needed. It can be hafazard. It can be as, you know, as bad as it is also. You don't have to worry. If you simply drop your interruption to this internal thing that is happening, it will settle on its own. It will come to a balance on its own. Like how the water, initially it was a lot of ripples, a lot of waves. It was total mess. If you settle it, within few minutes, it will settle and be balanced. It will be still. It will be absolutely still, right? Similarly, our mind will also do that balance, auto-balancing on its own. If you allow it, if you keep on interfering, then obviously it will not. If you allow it, it will come to a balance on its own. Yeah.
Okay, absolutely clear, Aya. Thank you.
Okay. I'm giving.
Thank you.
I'm giving mute to you. Then Satya, she had. I may unmute you. She had some question in the mind.
Yeah. So, Anandji, you answered very well. See, the mind just functions as it should be. Because we have to survive in this world, whether it is recording, not recording, everything is perfectly okay. But where we have to be careful is, you need not erase the conditionings, but you can transcend the conditionings by understanding these are the areas where you cannot tamper with. You have to simply accept.
Yeah, that's a byproduct, I can say. That's a byproduct. You don't have to worry about the conditioning, recording, all these things we don't have to worry about. Our action should be inaction, actually. We have to only understand that.
That is very, very difficult. The inaction is very difficult.
Yes.
Because we are so used to this kind of action.
Exactly. We are so used to getting in one direction. I know. Asking you to turn, you can take a U-turn. So that's the only problem.
Thank you so much.
So thank you. I think we have crossed our time well. 9:10 it is. If people want to ask the question, or Sanjay want to ask the question, anyway, I'll give unmute.
Yes,
Sanjay, you can speak.
Yeah, if it is, if time is running out, then maybe some next time.
You ask the question. Let us not.
No, actually, it is not a question. What I was thinking that, Anandji, as you were telling that if there is nothing to be done in the external world, then there is psychological pain inside. So, but we don't have to do anything about it. It is kind of that sounds to me like that is Stoic philosophy that be a man, suck it up and do your job. That is.
So, I mean, is that a question or a statement? I didn't understand what exactly.
I'm just saying that it just sounds to me that all it means is that be a man, suck it up, do your job. If there is just whatever is, if there is clarity, accept it and do your job.
Yeah, so I don't know what the terms you used, I'm not able to understand clearly, but yeah, if we are talking about psychological sense, in the psychological world, you don't have any role to play and the problem gets complex and bigger only because of our intervention, only because of our own knowledge that we are trying to, you know, trying to do something because of our knowledge, because of our thinking that, you know, I have to correct it or I have to do something here in the psychological sense. So here there is no role at all. We don't have to play anything, do anything here. But in the external world, we have to own the responsibility. We have to act responsibly. We have to do all those things with complete ownership. So that's the only difference. It's exactly opposite way it behaves.
Okay. Shakti Chirichi wants to ask.
Okay.
I think getting mute and mute problem. Sir, I'll give anyway unmute.
Okay. Yeah. I just want to say, from what I understand of what he spoke just now, see, this inaction feels very helpless and as though we are not attending to our life and like that. The inaction is very, very hard to understand.
Yes, see? Absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. That's what I said. Yeah.
That is really upsetting him. He says, you just accept everything, you just tuck it up and then you start doing that. It's not that. That inaction itself is an action in that moment.
Yeah, true. In fact, yeah. I think you must have all heard about this surrender, right? In Bhakti Yoga, there is a concept called surrender.
Yes.
So there also, what happens is in the ultimate, surrender is called the, I think is known as the ultimate stage in any spirituality, if you must all be aware. So there also, what happens is finally at one point, you're coming to a stage that I'm completely yours, whether it is body, mind, whatever. You surrender to God in Bhakti Yoga, it is to God, right? So what happens is I'm completely, my body, mind, soul, whatever it is completely yours. So from now on, it is your duty. You do whatever you want, whether it is bad, ugly, that is up to you. You have to take care and you have to be responsible to
correct
it or not correct it. It is your botheration. I'm not bothered anymore.
When you do this way, you don't keep correcting our own mind, standing against our own mind and doing it, but move like a child, move like a child.
So what happens there is in surrender, so finally, we ignore, disown the responsibility there. We pass on the responsibility to God or the deity, right? Whatever we believe in. So we completely ignore or disown all the responsibilities and we are kind of saying, I'm not bothered now. From now on, you take care whatever you want to do. That's what we are saying there.
But that inaction itself is an action. It's very hard to accept it.
Yes, so that is in the surrender. But what we are saying here is it's a scientific way of surrender.
Yeah, I know.
We are saying,
I like it. I like this.
Because we are saying that intelligence has no role here.
No role there.
Simply keep quiet.
It's very, very hard to accept for a mind which is all the time moving outside, no?
Yes.
In
so
action.
It is the same as surrender. We don't have to feel, negative or something about it. It's
you
the
feel
same.
So low as though we have not done anything. It's not that.
Yes.
There that's the inaction becomes an action.
Yeah, that's what I think I was explaining Rohini as well and some time back. In the external world, success is success. In the internal world, failure is actually success.
Okay. Yeah.
That's how it is.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Thank you. Emma, she wants to speak. I am giving unmute. Emma, please tell, where are you calling from? Yes, Emma?
Hello. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
I just say when Sanjay was saying about suck it up, actually, I just wanted to share about that. It's a local term. So you man up and you just suck it up and do what you got to do. So initially, it looks like there's no difference that we just have to feel that, you know, we are still doing everything in spite of all the pain. But then, except that after this understanding, the big difference is that we don't feel any more victimized and we feel that it is a choice, you know, it's not something that's forced on us, rather by choice you choose to do it and then bear the pain and still do because you could not do anything about the pain. So yes, we do suck it up and man up and do the job, but then we don't actually because we are free internally. So
Yeah, very true. I think, rightly said. Yeah. So initially it may feel like that, but Now I think we are like slaves. Now before understanding, we'll be like slaves. You have to, if worry comes, you have to worry. You know, live with that and keep on worrying about it till it leaves us. So, yeah, but now also, you have a choice.
Yeah, initially it's like, you know, yeah, what is the big deal? Like, yes, it's the same thing which we were doing it, you know, even before this understanding. But then after we really understand it, it's, there is a shift and it is different. We do suck it up, we do man up and we do think. But then we are not victim and we are totally free.
Yeah, it's, in fact, it's absolutely fantastic. Once you understand this concept, it, you will be completely free psychologically. You know, for example, just to maybe just for others to understand what is the benefit, I just wanted to say, like, for example, before my understanding, I just wanted to give my experience in form of how I felt it. Before my understanding, it was like hundreds and thousands of machines running in the factory. Like it was making that much of noise and chattering, always worrying about something, chattering, you know, why did I worry? How should I control? How should I do this, that and all? Some thousand machines running in my, you know, head. That's how I felt. Once I understood and once I, you know, surrendered myself, then it was like a complete, like a, how on a holiday or in a vacation, once you, if you stop all the machines, you know, how, you know, that kind of silence and peace is what I was feeling. And it has not left me, you know, till date. So it is like that. So that much of difference you will be able to feel. Once you stop this responsibility, take owning up all these, then you will see that things are smoothly flowing, you know, on its own way, on its own pace. You don't have to worry about anything at all. You'll be free completely inside. That's the benefit.
And one other thing I just wanted to add was, like, someone is asking, the whole thoughts and emotions is coming repeatedly because it is seeking a solution. And until we solve it or find a solution, it is, you know, it has a place and it keeps on repeating itself. But the only differentiation I would like to share is that sometimes we just have to live with some issues or problems which are beyond our scope to solve. So when the situation is like that, you know, when there is a problem in the external world, even though, you know, when we know that it's beyond our scope to solve it, but still we have to exist in that environment, then still the emotions and thoughts are going to completely repeat itself. So at those times, that's a distinction where we will feel relieved or free. Because we understand that, yes, there is a problem, but still we have to live with it. And it is beyond our scope to change anything about it, at least for that instinct or that moment.
True, true. I think with all this understanding, we will start accepting the reality. You will not be in an imaginary world of your own and trying to do something which is impossible things, etc. You will know what is reality. If there is a scope, yes, you will go and do it. As you said, if there is no scope, absolutely no scope, you will simply accept and, you know, move forward. Yeah.
Thank you.
Yama, you are calling from?
I'm calling from Pittsburgh, US.
Okay. So we will close it, the session at this moment. It's already 20 minutes past 9. Okay. So I thank Anand for doing this session nicely with us. Anyway, next week again we will meet and then we can have a question. Okay, sure. Thank you. Thank you very much.